Hey guys, and welcome to the Kilobits. My name is Francesca, and today I'm checking out Snek from Sumo Digital, which is out now on Xbox One, PC, PS4, and even the Nintendo Switch. So if you've got a Switch, this might just be a classic to add to your collection. And yeah, we're just kind of checking things out for today, so let's just jump into the game. Baldur's Realm 1 Paradise Path, let's go. So effectively, you play as this like snake hummingbird duo in this like really colorful creative world. It's a bit physics-based, and you have to kind of slither your way across the levels in your sneaky way in order to complete them. Noodle. I guess Noodle is the name of the snake. Oh man, what an inventive name. You know, because he looks like a noodle. So he's called Noodle. Wake up! Are we awake? We're waking up. Do snakes have eyelids? Something's wrong. The gate is broken. Right, we'll go fix the gate. If we don't fix it, we'll be stuck here forever. Okay, we better fix it then. So the thing is, right? I don't know if snakes have eyelids. Though I guess cartoon snakes have eyelids. But you can kind of see already that we've got this kind of lush, cartoony jungle environment, which I really like. We're a coral snake. You can tell because of our stripes. We're definitely poisonous. And I guess I have to collect all of these orbs as I go through the level in order to complete it. And maybe, like, once I've got all the orbs, I can complete the level. That seems to be the case. Ooh, a coin. Right, how do I get this? We'll just slither up here. There we go. Oh, I look so happy. Apparently you can change his expression. Let's try this. Oh, no, I look confused. Oh, I look really scared. What about this way? Oh, no. Wait, let's make him look really happy. And what's this one? Oh, mean. Oh, yeah. All right. No, we'll look really happy. There we go. We're just going to slither around with this stupid grin on our face. Pick up speed by slithering left and right with left stick. So I'm playing on PC. I'm using an Xbox controller, though. Like, this game just struck me as one that you definitely want to use a controller with. Ooh, a coin. Wait, how do I go back up? Oh, if I press A, I go up. Can I climb back up here? No. I feel like I didn't explore properly for coins. It doesn't really matter. I think if we miss some, then I think you can always replay the level. So if you're one of these people who likes the challenge and the replayability, you've got that option. But if you're kind of more of a speedrunner or someone who maybe finds the controls a bit challenging, then you're pretty good. Right, let's go. Lift your head by holding A. Okay, yeah, I kind of figured that one out. So I can kind of go up by holding A. But it seems to be this bamboo. My face looks so stupid with this expression. I'm gonna reset it to default. So it seems that, like, if you press A, your controller goes up. I'm just kind of keeping an eye out for coins now. So then you can kind of climb up things. But it's kind of weird because obviously you don't have limbs. So I feel like, you know, you can probably fall. And you're gonna have to be, like, maybe wind yourself around the different bamboo bricks, for example, in order to traverse. And I think later on it's gonna get more complicated. Whoops, we missed it. Come on, you can do it. There we go. Oh, look at that. Hey, what else have we got here? Ooh, goodies. So this must be the gate that the hummingbird was talking about, and we need to maybe get the pink thing for it. A keystone is missing from the gate. Okay, we need to find the keystone. I like it. It's like, we need to find the keystone that's right there and bring it back. This is kind of really fun. It's very different, actually. I've not played a game that's like this before. You know, I played a lot of games in my time, but I've not played one that's like this. Did I miss a blue thing? There's one there. Where's the last one? I think I missed one of the blue things. Ooh, is that a coin? That is a coin. We might have to try and get that coin, you guys. Even though it looks like danger. One sec. Oh no, that was it. Okay, cool. I thought I missed one, but we're good. So I can see a coin, like, hanging off this bamboo thing. So maybe I have to, like, try and climb up onto this. Can I like, coil my way around it? Whoa, I'm not coiled. I don't want to fall. Whoop, I don't want to fall to my death, because I think then I might have to restart the level. Right, there we go. Look, oh, look at this. Oh, whoa, nope. I was gonna say look at this superior sneaking, but it wasn't working. It's like slithering and going up at the same time is a bit awkward. Let's go up, and then. Oh, there we go. Look at that. Oh, nope. Come on, use your noggin. We actually don't need to go down here. We want to keep slithering. And then we can loop around. And then we've got grip. So that when we go onto this one. Can I just, like, stick my nose out and get it? Come on. Ay, look at that. Oh, professional. Professional levels of sneaking going on here. Like, I'm not saying that I was a Snek expert back in the day when I was a kid on my Nokia 3310, but I was pretty good at Snek, you guys. Right, what we got? The pink keystone. Let's grab this. I missed two coins by the looks of it. There's definitely a couple I haven't spotted. There may be, like, off some of those, like, bamboo nooks and crannies, so that's worth being aware of. So we got the keystone. We'll put it in there, and then I'm guessing something happens in the middle here. What have we got? In we go. Oh. Oh. Oh, I disappeared. Hey. Well, look at that. Oh, we missed two coins, but we are insane. Okay, well, let's continue and see where we go from here. Courtyard clamber. Why not? There must be, like, a good way to grip those, you know, poles. So I was really struggling with that, like, when I had to try and get that coin. And I feel like later on those kind of mechanics are going to come into play. Something here doesn't feel right. We should make sure that the gate is okay. It's interesting that all of these levels have a gate. Let's go. I wonder if there's going to be bosses. That would be really interesting. Do I spy a coin? No, that's not a coin. See, now I'm, like, obsessed with collectibles. I guess we'll just get on with it. Okay, up we come. We got one. What's over here? We'll slither our way over here. Can I get this one? I think I can. Come on. That wasn't too bad. I'm kind of scared that I'm going to have to climb in a situation where if I fall, I'll die. Because at the moment, you know, there's no real risk. Looks like we need to head up here. Okay, give me some more controls. Wrap yourself around the bamboo to climb up. Okay. What about over here? I want to get all these blue blobs. I don't know what the blue blobs do, but I definitely want to get them all. There we go, look at that. Oh, we are hench. Do you reckon there's a coin around here? I guess not. I thought there might be, like, up here or something. But it doesn't look promising. It's interesting how if you don't slither, so if you just try and go forward, you really don't have a lot of speed. Whereas if you do a wiggle and a jiggle, then you definitely pick up speed a little bit. Okay, have I gotten all of the blobs over here? I think I have. Is that one over there? One sec, we'll just go have a little bit of a peek. But I think that one's kind of far away. Yeah, I think there's a way around, so let's... Oh, there's a coin right there. I think there's a way around, so let's go up here for now. Okay, I guess we just wiggle around it. The problem is I'm going up too quick, so I'm wondering if maybe I have to kind of slowly go up. What is this? What is going on here? Press Y if you want me to give you a lift. What does that do? Oh, she grabs my fat tail. Press Y if you want me to let go again. I guess then you have, like, less grip, but it's maybe easier to get higher places. Oh, this is hilarious. There we go. Whoop, whoop. Come on. Come on. Oh my gosh. I can't believe someone's made a game where you control a snake. That's amazing. Like, I'm just kind of amazed. And also the controls actually don't feel too bad. Because, you know, this isn't your typical kind of control scheme. So the fact that they still feel quite intuitive seems good. And I imagine, like, the more that you play, the kind of better you'll get at it. And then you'll kind of be fairly adept. Because the thing I find right now is, like, going up is a little tricky. And making sure I'm wrapped around things. You know, that's definitely challenging. Alright, what have we got? I like how this is this, like, it's like, go left. Look at that. Look at this cheeky orb. Oh, you look so happy. Good job, Noodle. Good job. And I see, now whenever there's a corner, ooh, what's up there? That's an up. We'll maybe explore the up in a bit. I'm just, like, checking around all the corners because I want to make sure that I get everything. But how do I get to that up? We'll get this one for now. Or not. So there's a... Aha! There we go. There's some stairs there. Oh, what's this? In we come. Oh, that's cool. Where does this lead? I like how the camera changed there, because often camera angles in these sorts of games can be very janky. But you can obviously, like, change the camera with the right stick. So that's kind of cool. Oh, we got a checkpoint. Okay, cool. Right, we'll climb up here. I'm assuming that's a checkpoint. Oh, I have to climb... Do I have to climb the... Oh. I think I was meant to climb the bamboo. Oh, no. Are all the keystones missing? They are. Okay, so we're gonna have to find all of them. This really is terrible. I'm sure I can do it. I have faith in myself. Oh, look at that coin. Oh, come on! No, 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 no! What? Why? Why did the cutscene just kill me? I was, like, climbing up, and the entire time, apparently, my character was still moving. Right, at least it's not the end of the world. Alright, where were we going before we were so rudely interrupted by a cutscene? There we go. Maybe if I wiggle a little. Because I'm not very strong. This is what I've discovered. I want to go up here, though. I wonder if I can swim. I feel like snakes can probably swim. We can, in fact, swim. So that's a thing. Come on, get your blob. Oh, that's so good. Is there something behind there? Or is that just a reflection? No, okay, it's just a reflection. Right, let's try and climb up here and see how this goes. Oop. Come on, go up. Go up, there we go. It is a little bit tricky, like the climbing. But I think once you get the hang of it, it's probably not too bad. Oh, no, no, stay on here. So there, like, I kind of unwound too much. Whereas so long as I feel like, so long as you have a couple coils. No, go up, you silly snake. Oh, there we go. I like how he keeps going, whoa, I'm scared. No, you got this, you got this. Come on. You don't got this. I don't got this. Eh. Oh, look at that. That useful use of the bird. Okay, I'm not very good. I may or may not be very good. I think once you get his head onto something, it's quite good. But the problem is... like, you uncoil quite quickly. You may have noticed. So then it's a little bit tough. We're up here anyhow. So that's a thing. Let's go up here. This definitely needs to be climbed. Ooh, a coin. Oh, wait, where am I going? I should probably just, like... I'm holding down the slither button constantly. And I'm wondering if it would be a little bit easier if I just, like, wasn't constantly slithering. Because, like, right now, I'm slithering if I hold right trigger. So then if I stop, will it make my life easier? Not really. I'll bring my head up. Well, I can bring my head up without slithering. Oh, that's probably how you do it. So get your head up, stop slithering. And then, once you've got your kind of head where you want it to go, then slither. So maybe be a bit more slow and steady. Hey, look at that. All right, where do we need to go next? There's a blue thing there. There's a few more over there. There's the green keystone. I guess we just head towards the green keystone for now. Whee! Oh, that was fun. Okay. I suppose we'll have to climb down then. Oh man, I climbed all the way up here for nothing. Well, I got a coin. It wasn't really for nothing. Hey, I'm secretly a flying snake. See, that was totally fine. Is there something under the bridge? There's definitely... I don't know, the bridge just, like, was kind of an obvious one, that there would be something under it. Under we go. Hey. We'll go round. Keep going round. Oh, come on. I like how I was like, don't forget, you should just stop slithering and then direct your head and then slither. And I'm not doing that. I'm just constantly slithering. Ooh. Right, let's get this green one. Get a grip with left trigger as you wrap yourself around this. Wait, you can get grip? Oh, nice of you to tell me, game. I didn't realize I could grip things. Let's try this, right. I like how it takes until here for it to tell you that you have grip. So I guess what that means is that, like, while you're holding left trigger, you don't slither. And then when you let go, you slither. And then when you hold on, you stop slithering, and you can get grip. And then when you let go, you slither. Okay, this is way easier. Oh, look at this mechanic. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Right, come on. Get on here. I want to, like, bridge this gap. Whoa! Hey, look at that. Look at that. That definitely wasn't the way I was meant to do it, but whatever. Sweet. Sweet. Oh, okay, so this grip feature makes life so much easier, because you can just hold left trigger until you want to go, basically. And you won't, like, dash off. So that's really nice. I'm really liking this game, you guys. Like, it's just... it's very different. you know, the kind of cartoon duo is reminiscent of like the 90s, you know, like Ratchet and Clank, Banjo-Kazooie. You know, it kind of has that sort of feel to it, which is really nice. Because, you know, those games were really, really, really fun. And it's kind of different. Like, a lot of games nowadays, you know, there's other games out there that are similar. But in this game, it feels, you know, it feels very different from anything I've ever played. There we go. What have we got? And actually, the controls, you know, the controls feel pretty good, to be honest. Like, they don't feel too janky or anything. Yeah. I'm feeling it. I haven't seen any more coins, though. These coins are very, very sneaky. So they're like, I'm now gripping with my butt, so then I can climb up. I wish I'd known that on the first level. That's the one thing I would say is that, oh, there's a coin. Some of they could have taught you that earlier on, because I feel like it would have been really useful. But I mean, saying that, I am a snake. We'll get this coin. I need one more blue orb, I think. Did I miss one? I must have done. Does it really matter? Probably not. I'm just trying to see if I can spot it anywhere. It's maybe one of those ones that was hiding in like a corner or something. In which case, I might not find it. Yeah, not looking so promising for the blue orb anyway. We'll have a quick... Oh, there it is. I was going to say we'll have a quick look around and see if we can find it. All right, let's go. I am now a water snack. Oh, man. Feels good. Feels good. Up we go. Come on. Grab the orb. There we go. At least we got all the orbs. I feel like, you know, the orbs are the easier objective. The coins are much trickier to seek out. But all in all, we're pretty good. Right, come on. Wiggle like you mean it. Where's the ending? It's over there. Hey. And then the keystone opens and we go through the gate. I wonder what if there's like kind of a point to all these gates. You know, I don't really mind if there's not. You know, this isn't the sort of game that I feel has to have the like most in-depth story ever, because the gameplay is really, really solid. But, you know, a little bit of story is always fun. Especially if it, like, you know, makes the characters more endearing. Whee! Let's go up. And then the rapture occurred. And we got 3 coins again, I think. So we got the same score as last time. We are spectacular. Feels good. Right, I think we got time for, you know, one more level. We'll do Gatekeeper's Gardens. I think we got time for one more level, show off a little bit more of the game. And maybe see if any of the kind of mechanics or objectives or obstacles change. Well, here we are again. Sun shining. Check. Wind blowing. Check. Bird singing. Uh-oh. Oh, minor peril. That's the best kind of peril. So there's some kind of gigantic creature by the looks of things. Oh, I'm terrifying. Oh, look, he's doing his scared face. So something's going around the forest and removing the keystones and closing the gates. You always look behind you in these games, like, just in case. Like, so many games you get to the starting level, and then if you go backwards, it's like, and here is a secret. Okay, what we got? Up we go, I guess. I like how it keeps reminding you of the controls, just in case you forgot. Though, I think it's like, kind of... It's not actually too difficult. Now that I've got grip, the climbing anyway, like, I feel like, you know, the longer you played, the kind of better you would get at it. Right, we've got a keystone up there. Oh, and a coin. Well, that was the easiest coin I've ever found. Hey. What's this? We'll get that. And then we'll go get this yellow thing, I guess. Come on, do your thing. Grip. There we go. Because while you grip, you can then, like, wrap around, and then you're pretty good. So here we have grip. The only problem is, obviously, wrapping along this long one is kind of tricky. Press Y if you want to give me a lift. No, I don't need a lift. None of this. Oh, okay, maybe I did need a lift. Maybe I did need a lift. Hold my tail. And we'll do our grip. There we go. I think we can make it now. Oh, maybe I should climb higher. That would maybe be a little easier. I should probably get this thing to let go of my tail. Yeah, that was easier. Is there anything? Aha, see? I was gonna say, is there anything behind here? Oh, yeah. Secret Snek is at it again. Nah, we don't need grip here. We're gonna YOLO mode it. Right, what have we got? What have we got? We'll go up here, I think. And we'll get this one. I really like this game. Like, this is definitely something, like, I would recommend to people. It's so different and creative. I'm positively gushing. I mean, I kind of like, games with animal protagonists anyway. I have a zoology degree, so I was always kind of, when I was a kid, into, you know, Sonic and Crash and Spyro and all those kind of, well, I guess Spyro's not technically an animal. Well, I don't know, a mythical animal. But, like, I was always really into those kind of sorts of games when I was younger. So for me, this is, like, amazing. Because it's very, you know, it's very reminiscent of that. The colors are good. The gameplay is really, like, intriguing. Right, come on. There we go. Oh, look at that. That was top quality slithering. You know, if I was in Hogwarts, you know which house I would be? Frickin' slithering at this rate. Whee! Right, come on. But yeah, no, it feels really good. Like, it's kind of hard to explain unless you play it, but the controls feel pretty good. I think there's more if we keep going up. Let's go around this. Like, there's definitely something up here. Maybe a coin. Else, why would there be all these bamboo platforms? Aha. I guess I'll use the bird to lift up my tail. There we go. Okay. This is where I fall now. Oh, we're good, we're good. Hey, wee! Aw, we triggered the checkpoint, which is good. All right, where do we go next? Maybe up that kind of, is that like a slide? Oh, I want to go in the slide, you guys. I don't actually need to use this pipe thing now that I realize that, oh, this bar. How many of these blue things do we have? We'll grab this one. Come on. Not that many, actually. We're missing, like, 11? Is that one down there? That is one down there. Okay, don't let me forget that one's down there. I can't be bothered to go down there just yet, but we'll go down there later. There we go. Lift my tail. Oh, I got the slide one. I want to go down the slide, though. Like, the slide looks like fun. And fun is fun. Ooh, what's in here? Haha, look at that, you guys. That is the kind of one I would have missed. Right, wiggle your way back this way. Good job. Good job, Noodle. Was there something I needed to climb? I think there was. Yeah, I guess up these, this like climbing frame over here. I can hear a glittering noise over there. Like here? I wonder if this like symbol means anything. There's definitely some kind of glittering noise. I mean, I wonder if the coins have sound cues. I think it must be further up, whatever it is. So let's climb up and we'll have a look from further up. The only thing is I also need to, you know, obviously check to make sure I haven't missed anything while we're here. Right, there's one in the corner. We'll go get that one. Oh, but then there's a climbing frame here. Now I don't know which climbing frame to climb, you guys. Up we go. We'll take this one for now. And then we'll go from here. I just like it. I think the level design is really cool. There's loads of, like, stuff to explore, which is fun. Right, put your head up. There we go. Grip. And up. And grip. Hey. And up. Up. And grip. Oh, I really want to see this game speedrun now. Like, next GDQ. We gotta have some snake pass. Because, like, I don't know. I feel like seeing this at some kind of, like, you know, professional level would be really cool. Is this a checkpoint? It is. Can we see any coins? I can't see any. And then there's a blob down there, which we can get. Is there one further up? Yeah, I think there's probably something up here. Yeah, there's a blob. Okay. Right. I know where at least three more of these blue orbs are. We need... Okay, I know where two more are after this. So we're missing one then. Let's see, there's one there. There's one over there. Okay, I know where they all are. This is where I could hear the glittering noise. Can't hear it anymore. I wonder if that symbol on the wall means anything. Let's go down the slide. Like, oh my god, it's amazing. Whee, look at us go. Like, I'm wondering if this means anything. It's not glittering anymore, so maybe not. Oh man, but we're missing two coins. This is gonna annoy me. Every level we get three out of the five coins. Okay, so now we need two more orbs. I'll go get those orbs anyway, and then we'll go from here. Alright, wiggle like you mean it. It's kind of funny, you're obviously, like, you know, going further by wiggling, but you get more speed. Which is realistic, because this is obviously how snakes move. And I kind of like that that's something that they've put into the game. Like, they've kind of thought about it, which is really cool. Right. Let's go. Mr. Snek. Yeah, snacking it up. It's okay. I like how the bird keeps panicking. He's like, don't forget to use your grip. We got this. I'm now an expert. Okay, let's have a quick look while we're here, just if we can spot anything coiny. What this usually means, if I can't spot them that easily, is that they're behind something. Oh, there's one up there. Oh, how do I get up there? Maybe we can jump from the top. That means we're going to have to climb back up and do like a heroic snake jump. Okay, I want to get this coin, you guys, so we're going to do that. Like, completion matters. Up we go. Round we go. Whee! Okay, let's go. Further up. Oh, we're not doing it. What is this? I've become an amateur. Hey, there we go. It's also kind of cool because it's like, you're kind of imagining like being a snake and how a snake would move, if that makes sense. Like, Jesus Christ, having no legs and no arms must be such a stressful existence. Okay, where's this coin? There. Right, we're gonna do a Herculean snake leap of faith. Oh, look at that. Oh, it was amazing. I am amazing. Right, so I guess we're missing one coin now. I'll just have a quick look to see if I can spot it, but you know, I'm okay with four coins. The only thing I wonder is, you know, if you replay the level, do you have to find every single coin again or only the ones that you missed? Because I feel like, you know, only finding the ones that you missed would make the most sense. But maybe you have to get them all. Who knows? I do like this extra feature though. This is definitely the kind of game I could see myself spending hours and hours like exploring just to try and find the collectibles and stuff. And I know some people are like super into collectibles. Ah, we can't see it. Right, let's just wrap up the level. In we go. Oh man, this is so fun. Super happy. Hey, look at that. And, oh, it's like a bird. It's like an evil bird. You saw the shadow there. We got all the blue things and we got four coins. Not quite 100%, but you know, pretty decent. Well done you. Yeah, well done us indeed. Well done us indeed. And then we've got Creeping Causeway is the next one. And you can see, you can go back and you can see how far you've done. And I'm wondering if getting all the collectibles maybe unlocks something. I'm not really sure. But yeah, guys, this has been Snake Pass and it's been super duper fun. I'm really enjoying it. And if you want to see more, maybe we could turn this first impressions into a Let's Play. Do let us know in the comments below. Like, we don't really know what you guys want to see from the channel unless you tell us. And if you like this video, then hit that thumbs up button. I am so excited to play this game. Like, it's if you guys don't want to see a Let's Play, I'm probably just going to play it in my free time. But, you know, if you guys do want to see me play it and go through the game, again, let us know. Beyond that, you know, you can see all of our social media on the screen. So if you want to support the Kilobits or find us anywhere on the social medias, that's where you can find us. Thanks for watching. Have a fantastic day. And maybe I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye.